Hey, where do you think you're going? Oh, is that right? Work? Nuh-uh. You got bitten 3 days ago. You're still in the process of changing. If you go to work today, you're going to either pass out of exhaustion because your body is absorbing all of your energy on the internal process of becoming a werewolf. Or you're going to eat every single edible thing in sight because your body needs the calories to fuel the fact that, oh yeah, you're becoming a werewolf. Look, call in sick today. You can probably make it in tomorrow. Tell them the partial truth. You were out hiking and you got attacked by something and need a day to recover. No, don't tell them you were attacked by a wolf. We don't need them to report it to animal control. The wolves in this area are vital to the ecosystem. Tell them you didn't see what attacked you. Okay. You can move around. I don't blame you for being restless, but don't leave the cabin. Me? I've been cooking. Of course I have, because I am now taking care of another adult who is turning into a werewolf. Or has been turned into a werewolf, rather. We burn a lot of calories, and you're gonna need a lot of fuel right now. The process is an energy intensive one. Hence why I passed out for 3.5 days when I got bitten. But hey, you were only out for two, so you're recovering pretty quickly still, and there's definitely something to be said for that. What? No. No. Me taking care of you and taking you in does not make us a pack. There's no such thing. Yes, actual wolves run in packs. Yes, humans are aggressively social and require a lot of interpersonal interaction in order to be healthy. Yes, you would think that those two instincts would combine and make werewolves extremely tight-knit pack creatures. That's not the case. Being a werewolf is an extremely isolated experience. We don't do packs. We don't feel the need to be around others of our kind at all costs. It's the opposite, actually. Werewolves tend to get threatened by others of their own kind. Not necessarily in human form. Like this, I don't mind being around you. You're just another person. Someone who I hope will become a friend. But for now, I am perfectly content to consider you an acquaintance. And I would hope you would do the same for me. And that's fine. We barely know each other. However, when the full moon comes and we transform, we should not be anywhere near each other if you want to survive. Bold statement for a newly turned werewolf. You actually think you could beat me in a fight? Oh, there's a lot of different factors, but the fact that I have been a werewolf for many years at this point pretty well implies that I'll have more control over it than you. I mean, don't get me wrong, we can't control our wolves. They're a separate entity that happens to be sharing our physical body. There's no transform and then I recognize you so I won't attack you. No, there's none of that. It's more, I transform, I see another werewolf that's a threat. You don't know how to fight as a wolf. I do. And when I transform back into a human the next morning, I wake up with your corpse on the ground. That's how this would go. It's not going to go that way because we're not going to be anywhere near each other, but that is how it would go if we were. Don't worry, I'm gonna make all the arrangements when the full moon comes for both of us because I do, in fact, want you to survive your first moon. Surviving the first full moon is something of a rite of passage for werewolves. A lot of us don't. That's why there aren't very many. Well, that and the hunters, and the fact that werewolves typically don't reproduce, but I told you all that already. So, no, there is no pack. You are not in my pack. I don't have a pack. That's not how this works. I mean, if you want, you are welcome to try when you're ready and you can leave here and go back to your life without me trying to guide you every second of every day through this new change. If you want to go try and form a pack, fine. See exactly how many werewolves would actually listen to you on that. Well, see, here's the thing. I knew a werewolf. He was older by quite a bit from me. He was in his 50s. And I was pretty newly turned at the time. It had been 6 months, maybe. I came across him and I asked him basically the same question. And what he told me is that he had tried when he was my age to make a pack with a few even younger wolves who had gotten turned way too early. He wanted to do for them what I am doing for you, but he didn't yet understand the mechanics of lycanthropy and the werewolf mind. He woke up the next morning with six juvenile wolf bodies around him, covered in blood. Which sounds pretty nasty, to be perfectly honest with you. I don't really do well with that kind of stuff, and I'm a werewolf too. I cannot tell you how many times I have woken up covered in blood. And it's never fun, and it takes forever to get out of your skin, and then you end up smelling like a deer for like 3 days, and it's awful. But point being, there's no packs. That's not how this works. Which, I mean, I've been fine with. I was already a pretty quiet, introverted person by nature anyway. So, it's not a big deal to me, but if you're one of those extroverted people who have to be around at least one other person at almost all times, or else you start feeling yourself go a little bit skiwampus, then I'm sorry, but you are going to have to adapt, my friend, because that's not how this works. No, it's an important question. I mean, they say there's no such thing as stupid questions. That's obviously not true, but this is not a stupid question. This is, in fact, a very important question. And I just realized I have not even touched the thing that I was doing on the stove. One second, I'm gonna scald that frickin' pot again. Hang on. Sorry, where were we? No, the potatoes, they're, I managed to save the pot from getting scalded, thank goodness. But only barely. But yes, potatoes. Yeah, they're fine. Where were we? Yes, I'm a little scatterbrained, okay? I'm a little overwhelmed at the moment, and you should be too. Because you have just had your entire world turned upside down. I've had my world turned upside down for the last several years. That's a good question. It's been a while. Probably. Oh boy, how old was I when I got bit? It's been about. Oh, yeah. It's been about 7 years. Yeah, I was pretty young. I mean, obviously, I still look like a teenager, but that's just because I'm small. It's not because I am young. I'm older than I look. Which apparently means that when I'm, you know, a lot older and I still look like I'm young, I will be grateful for it then, but when I'm this age and I want to be taken seriously now, it can get a little bit irritating. But that's fine. I'm more than used to it at this point. Anyway. Yeah. We were talking about packs. No such thing. Being a werewolf is pretty isolating. I'm gonna do what I can for you while we're in human form, and then when the time of the month comes for wolves, that is when we'll make arrangements to be far, far away from one another when the moon rises. And I will also be the one making sure that when the moon rises, we will be far, far, far away from any humans. Because to the mind of a transformed werewolf, a normal human is essentially a tasty snack. And that is something that I believe we both want to avoid. I've managed to avoid it this far, and I intend to keep doing that until I die. So, arrangements will be made. Anyway, how bad is your cabin fever? Like, how bad do you want to be outside? Okay. Yeah, no, that sounds pretty normal. I'm gonna go outside and mow the lawn. I mean, it's a pretty tiny yard because the forest is pretty close on all sides, but I do still have to mow the lawn. I'm gonna go mow it. You are welcome to sit outside. I've got some deck chairs. Just stay within the yard. Don't run out into the trees because I am strong enough to drag you back. I just really don't want to, because it's not very pleasant through the woods. These are very dense woods. So, you can come sit out on a deck chair if you want, and then if you pass out there, it'll be a lot easier for me to drag you back inside, so that you can actually let your body recover from the transformation process, because it's not quite done. It should be soon. You should be fine to go into work tomorrow, but it's not quite done. Anyway, dinner? The potatoes are done, and the meat should be out of the oven in about two. Great. How about you go sit at the table, and I will get the food out. Cool. Oh, this will be nice. Great.